Hello, friends! So last week, I briefly mentioned in my video that I got laid off by my company and I'm currently jobless and in between job. Don't get me wrong, I'm fine doing what I'm doing right now and I needed this break to kind of do things that I like, for example, this YouTube video. But I do find myself often in a place where I do things that are different from my peers, that is different from the traditional route of career options, stuff like that, and I want to talk about how I stopped comparing myself to others. I grew up in a really competitive environment because I went to a Chinese school, and you know how Asian parents are like, they are really pushy towards their kids, and so my classmates were all really competitive people. I think our classroom average is always like 95 and above, and I think I'm pretty confident that up until secondary school, I have never gotten a B in my life before. I know it sounds so Asianly geeky and good, but that's the reality of it. And it's not to say that I don't have a good childhood. I did get to do a lot of arts. My parents love arts a lot, so they're always supportive of me doing artistic stuff. And I also have friends and cousins to play with as I grew up. But I think I just want to say, like, I did grow up in a competitive environment that makes me compare myself to others a lot. And eventually when I go to secondary school and university, I tend to be more on the chill side, but I do compare myself to my peers every now and then, especially when I was in university. Because I was an international student in Canada, I was really conscious about my Malaysian accent and how I'm not confident enough to participate in classes because I'm not used to critical thinking or discussion-based classes. So I felt really inferior in the classes. I compared myself to my peers and I wasn't doing good at all. But eventually I did kind of work things out. I realized that as an international student, I'm so much more stronger than my local friends because I have to be independent. I can't just go back to my parents and cry, and I don't have my parents to, like, you know, cook for me when I go home or do my laundry. Like, I had to do everything on my own. And somehow when I realized that I am uniquely myself and I'm a pretty cool international student, I started doing better in university. And then, like, post-graduation happened. I graduated from university and I realized that a lot of my friends, they already got job offers or they already know what they want to do and they're like super gung-ho about their pursuit. And there I was. I wasn't doing much. And I felt pressured to just get into the bandwagon and just start joining the rat race, and that's what I did. I applied to many companies and I accepted the first job offer that I received. I know, so quickly. But it's also like a good offer. It was a good company, good compensation. It was all good. That's why I took it. That definitely, like, at that point, I felt like that was the best decision I could make. But eventually, after that, I wasn't happy. And it's a combination of factor because I had reverse culture shock moving back to Malaysia after staying in Canada for 4 years. I had some traumatic incident triggers, and again, I wasn't happy. I didn't like the job that I was doing. And so I fell into a really huge mental health break. That's like a full video that you can watch. I'll insert the link above. But yeah, like, eventually I had to take a mental health break, and that period of time I think is when I really learned to not care or not compare myself to other people. During that time, maybe the first 2 months was really about recovery, but after that it was a lot of just sitting back and thinking what exactly I want in life. That was also when, like, instead of participating in the race with all my peers, I really just sat back as an observer and start looking at what people are doing instead of, like, comparing it with myself. And I realized that yes, I have friends who are doing really well in their job, they are getting promoted, they are doing great, but I also have friends who are still in university, whether it's by choice or because they failed and they don't have a chance. But that's when I realized, like, we are all on a different path. We are all moving towards a different direction. I have friends who are really into fitness and they were just going ham and like really getting that fit body that they really want. But that's not what I really wanted. I mean, it's nice to have a fit body, but I really work out just to have a healthy body and a stronger body, but I wasn't going for a super lean, supermodel body. And I have friends who are traveling, And I have friends who are traveling around that were going to different places, but that's not exactly what I want either. Like, yes, it's nice to travel everywhere, but that's not my first priority in life and life goal. I travel to learn things, I travel to relax, but ultimately traveling is not what I really want. I realized that we all have different pursuit and we all have different goals, we all have different path that we want to take. And there's no point comparing yourself with someone who is on a different path, a completely different journey with yours. I think that was when, like, I really just sat back and looked at everyone else and I realized, like, hey, I'm just a tiny speck of dust in this universe and I'm doing things for myself. Whatever I do, it takes me to where I'm leading, it takes me to where I want to go. And whatever my friend does, it takes her to where she wants to go in that journey that is meant for her. There is no point comparing ourselves because we're just different individuals, we're different human, we have a different story to be written. And definitely, like, living at this age where social media is so prevalent, it is always telling us all the different information about our friends. A scroll on Facebook and Instagram can tell you what your friend is doing, where they are going, what they are wearing. And it's easy to just compare yourself to them when you are constantly being fed all this information. So one thing that I did that kind of helped me control my comparison with friends is I controlled my social media usage. I deleted Twitter and Snapchat from my phone because it's just too much social media channels. And so right now I'm left with Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Pinterest. And Pinterest is not really social using. I use it just for like pinning stuff. And YouTube, I just make video and do stuff that I really enjoy and watch videos that I love. So that too, I wouldn't really consider them to be like a major social media influence in my life. It's mainly Facebook and Instagram. And right now, after a lot of trial and error, I feel like I found that pace in me to use social media really wisely. One thing that I did is I removed Facebook and Instagram off from the homepage in my Android. And so whenever I want to use Facebook and Instagram, I would have to consciously go to all my apps and look for the app. So it makes it more of a conscious decision instead of, like, you know, just queuing up in McDonald's and just automatically go to that shortcut and just mindlessly scrolling. I do it less now because I have to consciously go to my app page and look for that app and use it. And definitely being more mindful of how what people do doesn't correlate with what I do, it really helps me to scroll social media without much judgment in my phone. And that helps me a lot in not comparing myself to others too. I really enjoy social media now. I don't use it as impulsively and as like mindlessly as before. And I still get to catch up with my friends' stuff, but I just stop comparing myself and I just stop thinking about what I could be doing to what they are doing. I really think that social media has played a huge part in our life that makes the millennials and like the younger generation to really compare ourselves to others all the time. And a lot of time we compare ourselves based on metrics that are just not as important, like number of followers, number of likes. Yes, it's cool to have a lot of followers, but if they're all fake, if they're all bought, how does that even make you happier? Because they're all not real. You're just living in an illusion that you have a lot of followers or you have a lot of likes, but they're not real people. Isn't that creepy? Oh, I don't know how people live with this mentality these days. But yeah, I'm definitely doing things that are different from my peers. I'm trying to grow my social media. I'm trying to start my own online business, which is a really exciting thing to do. And it's what I'm passionate about. When I had to... Oh yeah, I should talk about this. So when I was jobless during my mental health break for 8 months, I actually got to start a henna business because someone noticed about my talent and asked me to start a stall in a flea market, and I did it. And it was a great experience. That was kind of like the start of my entrepreneurial experience, and I really enjoyed just doing a business that is art-based and just working for myself. It was something that I realized I really love, and that was that thing happened when I stopped comparing myself to my friends and do things according to my own will at my own pace. And I would say like that mental health break was so different from everyone else. Like, it's so different and unplanned, but it really taught me a lot in this journey that I am so open to whatever chances and opportunities this life is taking me to. That's which is why right now I really want to start my own business and to do things that I love without following the traditional routes. Of course, I do have freelance to sustain me, and I do have a job lined up that is aligned with my long-term goal. And I think it's fine to, it's not to say that everyone have to be their own boss, you have to quit your job to do things that you like, but really it's just like moving towards the path that leads to where you want to go. It doesn't mean that you have to quit your job tomorrow, but if your goal is to really work for yourself, then like plan your path right now. At least move towards the direction that you want to go, and then eventually quit your job. It is okay to do things that is different from everyone else. You don't have to always compare yourself to everyone. You don't have to do things that is expected of you. Just do whatever that's your heart's desire. I hope you enjoy this video. I really enjoy not comparing myself and to do things that I enjoy right now. And I hope that you're able to really fight that inner voice that keeps comparing yourself and keep judging yourself too. I hope you love this video. Comment down below if you've managed to stop comparing yourself to others, and if your method is different from mine, if it's not just social media, please share it with me because I would love to learn from you too. I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification bell if like you love videos that are self-love, confidence, and all this personal talk. I love doing all this, so you're gonna expect a lot of these videos coming up. And be sure to share this with your friend if you think that they're like comparing themselves with others a lot. I will see you in my next one next week. Goodbye. Bye, 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 bye.